真好。
That's okay.
Cloud Temple in Chinese is Bai Ming Guan, Bai Ming White Cloud, and this is a Taoist temple. It was first built in Tang Dynasty, that was in 6th century, and it was getting famous from 13th century, that's the Yuan Dynasty. Taoism is the rooted Chinese religion. Taoism has a history more than 2,000 years old. Built by the Empress Dowager.
This is a very important place. It's a very special place. It's a very sacred place. For so many times, so long time, mm-hmm. people cultivated here.
Yes.
And so the cultivation, cultivation is what the Taiji is about, from Wuji to Taiji, of how do we get to be here? How do we get to this form? And that's what this teaching is about. That's what the Taiji is about. It's a method to transform something. And that transformation takes place by doing motion and movement, and to move the energy, so the energy comes back into harmony as well.
而且白观始建于唐朝，就是皇家李氏家族为了供奉太上老君所建的一所庙，叫太极宫。Generally
translate his words. He said, every master or monk or Taoist, why they become monk or Taoist? It's the previous life. Now everybody has lots of previous life. So he said, he becomes a Taoist monk because of his previous life. You are relaxed all the time, soft, relaxed, warm all the time. That means you have enough cultivation. So very good. In the past, the Taoist master, they lived in the deep mountain. So they needed to take care of themselves well. So they have to know what kind of herb is good to their body.
Bye.
Forms?
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're going to go up there.
Hello, Har Har.
Hi. We're on our way to Chen
there
Village.
We go. All right. Look at that building behind you. It's really awesome.
Yeah.
This is.
Last questions anyone has?
No.
Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. I'm also very happy that.
Civil from Dan Tien in the oldest writings.
So
the oldest writing, that's where
they abbreviated it to make it be just the two and one for Qigong, Gong, 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 Gong.
Greater, and the Tai Chi is just beginning to form, but it hasn't entered yet.
Right.
On the left here, you see it more. You see the circle is empty, and underneath it is yin on the right, yang on the yin on the left, and then reverses are underneath that. Goes yang yin.
Right.
Yeah.
It just says this is the happiness.
Picture, yeah.
Picture.
Remember, this is the
right. Then the bow shoot the arrows right. In a different position. Not quite sure what this one is, so.
So
it's different. It's different variations of some of the ones. Another form of two hands holding feet. There's more than what we know. So originally they had these. They had I think there's 50 here, but there may have been 32 that I was told. And of the 32, eight were created that we keep. That's what we call eight is a special number. So The Bagua Jin means the eight forms or eight movements. They originally came from these older, more of the warm-up exercises.
The eight great movements for health.
Exactly. It's not related at all. But I said, this says Qigong. This is the modern character for Qi. That's the modern theory for Gong.
He was the current leader of Buddhism in India, but he left and he came here. And the reason he came to China, the story goes, is that there was the next successor was here, and he had to come find him. So he was a Taoist, but because Bodhidharma had the clear insight, the greater wisdom, he knew that he was here, but he didn't know exactly where he was. So he comes and he finds a temple that this new successor is actually teaching at. So when he goes to the temple, he says, he asks them a question that's something like, have you seen your original face? Or do you know your true nature? And he got mad. The Chinese monk got mad that he asked him this. He said, you come to my country, you're a foreigner. How dare you ask me such a question? So Bodhidharma said, oh, I'm sorry, excuse me. And he leaves. Well, when he leaves, the 9 years story is that he started wandering through China. He knew that it would take him longer to figure out what happened. So his introduction to him wasn't accepted. But then after he left, the Taoist monk realized, oh, I made a mistake. I was rude. Like, I was rude to Tristan the other day. So I was like, I was rude. And so he realized he made a mistake. He said, he had some information. I don't know my original self. I haven't seen my original face. I better go find him and find out like what he knows that I don't know. So he did the art of investigation, the Kowu. So he then starts following, trying to find Bodhidharma, and it takes 9 years. So he finally finds him at this cave where he's hanging out at. And he comes in and he says, oh, I'm so sorry I was rude to you. What do I need to do in order to see my original face? And Bodhidharma says, you must get rid of your attachments. So, but the word attachment also has the word for show, or for hand. And so he says, you must. So he hears it as, you must get rid of your hand.
And so he immediately takes out his knife from his pocket that everyone carried when they traveled, and he chops off his own hand. Because he said, I got to get rid of my attachments. So Bodhidharma sees this, and he takes his robe off, and he wraps it around to stop the bleeding. And that's the story why they say the monks will have the red robe to this day to commemorate that first meeting, that first experience. Yeah. And then it was passed on to him, so he became the first Buddhist patriarch here in China.
Imagine starting like this. I said, I started when I was 18.
So the kids bored here.
Blood and to sleep around, so the snow become red. So Dhammo just accepted him.
And this is where it happened, right?
Just there.
Just here is where.
Yeah, just in here.
Red
so that's why you know the monks now their jasa, their coat, yeah, have what a red, you know, red and yellow.
Break up the.
That's where they practiced.
Hello?
Beautiful.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, check this out. Yeah.
Kuan Yin.
Yep. And we can all do Tai Chi on that first level we came
that would be
into,
wonderful.
That grotto.
Yeah.
The rocks behind us.
You know, we were walking through a cave and I'm like, what's this place? You know, and then suddenly it opens up to Wudong Mountain.
Yes.
So, when she poured the tea, just to drink it quickly, not till it's getting cold.
Use the cup will make the taste of the tea more pure.
And hot is better for the body.
You need to insist on
have a big house for all your calligraphy.
I don't have to have a big house to sit there the whole day. I love that, but I cannot.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a working age.
So this is Master Ming Yue. So everybody, we may do this and say, 师父好, okay? 师父好. Thank you.
你好。
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 Okay, so everybody knows the name of this mountain, Wudang Shan, Wudang Mountain. And what is Wudang? Have you thought about that?
No.
Okay.
Quite honestly.
Wudang. Okay, so this mountain, we have so many famous mountains in China. And we've been to Shaolin Temple. I told you the five highest ones. We call them five yue. But besides that, we have famous mountains like Wudang too. But who is Xuan Wu? Actually, Xuan Wu is one of the stars in the sky. For ancient China, we say that on the four directions, there are stars. There are seven stars in each direction. Xuan Wu, I said he is one of the guard in charge of the direction. And what is the direction? That's the north. North direction. And what is north? North is water, right? So Xuan Wu was an animal, actually. It was the combination of snake and turtle. He represents the water. So he's the god of the north, or god of the water. And why people just put him on this mountain? And Wudang Shan represents fire. So you see that if a mountain is with lots of fire, that's not good, right? That's not safe. So people just put the god of Xuan Wu here, and he just sits on the top of the mountain, so he can put water on the fire. So the trees are, in other words,
very. Our god's ticklish.
Forbidden.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I think that means
precious culture.
I love the building. I love the tea here.
Is east is the other direction.
So inside. So you take the water, the yin out of the fire, and you put it all the way over into the water. And you take the yang from the water and put it all the way over to the other side. Now that becomes heaven and earth. That's the cultivation, that's the transformation. So if you could do that, that's called the merger of the common leaf. If you could make this happen, then you would have a great understanding.
Yeah.
Delicious. Cool things. So I said on my website the Wu style form I have is filmed here.
Oh, so this is so it's fading.
Yeah.
I don't have cash. I will, yes. Everywhere.
That's amazing. You can pay with your phone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I love the smell. Mm-hmm. I'll eat. Want to share?
You know, Jiayi has cultivated here for more than 30 years. Like that. Actually, it was a very simple case. Because he stayed here and practiced cultivating. So, day by day, and the local people knew that. And they came to bring food from Jiayi and we have tea.
And he'd already been here for 20 years.
Absolutely. And not like a lot of things you think. No, but. That's
okay.
See, around
there
is a river, always. That's the Belt River. And according to Feng Shui, Shui is very important. And in lots of cities, in ancient time, most of
axis in the middle of the courtyard, and most of the main halls are on the axis, so it is going up in Buddhism too. But in the White Cloud Temple in Beijing, it's different because there's no mountain there, huh? We just go in. But usually, most of the mountains are on mountains.
Purple Heaven Temple. Heaven.
Heavenly. Purple heavenly temple. Yeah.
Purple.
Oh, purple.
Very good tea. Okay, so you may.
Oh, she came back.
Just,
yeah,
give me tea house.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
I don't know what it is.
It's very happy with that.
不学习我都很开心。
You're welcome. Run away. And they call the master. Like this.
吹动，我们想邀请你到外面弹，很好听啊。